Hey everyone, Gamer LCD here, and welcome to episode 2 of the Gamer's Rant, audio podcast show in which I discuss all of the latest trends and topics and give you guys all of my opinions on all the latest gaming news that is constantly being put out to the public. So for today's episode, we're going to be talking about the new Xbox 720 and all the new information that just came out about what's going to be coming with the Xbox, and as well as the new features that the new Xbox is going to have. So let's go ahead and dive right into this. So just recently, a new article was made available to the public a couple of days ago, and in this document, I might as well add that this was a 56-page document that was officially released to the public, and it talks about all this new, it talks about a whole bunch of stuff that Microsoft has had planned for this new Xbox to be released in at the end of 2013. Now, it has been there has been speculation that Microsoft was going to be announcing this new console, not at this year's E3 that's already passed, but at next year's E3 2013. But there's even more speculation that this new Xbox will be unveiled before E3. So all we can do right now is wait, but what I want to talk to you guys about today in this podcast has all to do with this new information that was in this so-called 56-page document. Now, I am taking this information from GameSpot and other various sources, so there has to be some credibility to this document. I really don't think that someone is going to fake a 56-page document, and I really don't think that if major gaming news websites like IGN and GameSpot are going to be posting about information that's false or, you know, things like that. So there does have to be some credibility to this document, and hopefully most of these things that are true that I'm getting ready to talk about. So let's go ahead and dive right in here. So the first thing that's mentioned in this document, of course it's over a course of 56 pages, but I'm just going to go ahead and summarize all the cool things that were mentioned inside this document. I also want to mention that this document was printed or was written back in the middle of 2010, so some of this stuff could be inaccurate, but most of it should still be pretty good, as you know, most major Fortune 500 companies are always going to have advanced yearly plans to figure out what they want to do with their products or whatever they are doing in a timely manner. So I just wanted to point that out there, but let's go ahead and dive right in there. I've done it. I'm talking about this document. So the first thing that I wanted to mention is that the new Xbox is not called the Xbox 720. I know, a shocker, right? A lot of talk was going on that it was going to be called the Xbox 720, like a couple months after the Xbox 360 come out. People were talking like, you know, when's the new Xbox coming out? I bet it's going to be called the Xbox 720. But, you know, the reality is it's not called the Xbox 720. There is an official code name that was given to this new Xbox called the Xbox Durango. Now, whether or not this is going to be the official name of the Xbox is unknown at this point, but that is the official code name, and usually code names do get transferred over to official names later on. But there's also another name for this Xbox that has been pitched. And when I say pitched, I mean it's an idea that has been tossed around for the actual official name of this new console, and that name is called the Xbox Charisma. The Xbox Charisma. Now, when you think of the Durango and the Charisma, you don't really say to yourself, "Ooh, hey guys, you want to go play on the new Charisma?" I mean, it just doesn't sound right. You know, with the Xbox 360, it kind of rolls off your tongue and it sounds right. You know, when you go in to talk to your friends, you're like, "Hey guys, you want to go play some 360? You know, that sounds cool." But if you go to your friends and say, "Hey guys, you want to go play some Charisma?" Like, they're gonna be like, "What the hell are you talking about?" So, I don't really know if Microsoft's gonna be sticking to those two names or not, but hopefully they come up with something better than Charisma and Durango. But let's go ahead and move on to some of the new features. They announced Kinect V2. Now, basically this Kinect V2 is going to be able to adapt with new technology, to adapt to people's living rooms, meaning they won't have to move furniture around. And basically they'll get the optimal experience without having to hold a controller in their hands, and they'll be able to do what they want in any type of environment. You could be in a completely dark environment, you can be a completely bright environment, it won't matter. The new Kinect will be able to be the most advanced technology motion capture software out there. So that's Kinect V2. Kinect V2 will be launching with this new Xbox, whatever it's going to be called. And there's also a new feature that's supposed to be launching with the Xbox. Well, not with the Xbox, but it's supposed to come out early, or it's supposed to be coming out early 2014. And basically, it's going to be called, it's going to be called Fortalza. And basically, what Fortalza is augmented reality glasses for the new Xbox. And so, basically, what they're planning with these new augmented reality glasses is that something Nintendo was working with back in the day when they started their first systems. They had these glasses that you could wear, and basically, it was an entire video game in the glasses where you could just play this game that you were seeing and didn't have to watch on a TV. It would just be right in front of your face with these glasses. And that's basically what Microsoft is planning with these new augmented reality glasses, that you're going to be able to wear them, and without playing your game on the TV, you can be watching and playing the game through these glasses and seeing what's going on and interact through the Xbox through 4G and wireless connections from the glasses to your Xbox. So I don't really know if that's something people are interested in or not, but I really don't find myself using augmented reality glasses. I like having a controller in my hand, and I like pushing buttons. Even with Kinect now, I do not like using Kinect, and I've never been a fan of the Wii either. As soon as I heard the Wii and you had to it was motionless and things like that, you had to hold these things in your hands, and it's just not my type of gameplay. I like having a controller in my hand, I like smashing buttons, I like having some skill and some triggers and things like that. With a motionless controller like the Kinect, you really don't have as much control over the game as you would like, because the technology of the Kinect and the Wii can only do so much, and it has to kind of compensate for the lack of motion that you're probably giving the machine to work with. So I've never been a fan of motionless things like that, so I'm not really looking forward to Kinect or this new Kinect or this new augmented reality glasses or anything like that. But like I said, it is supposed to be launching sometime after the new Xbox comes out in the end of 2013, and then the glasses is supposed to come out sometime in 2014. So let's go ahead and dive into something that you guys must be really eager to hear about, such as I was when I finally first heard this. So Microsoft has decided and has made a deal with Sony to put Blu-ray optical drives inside their new Xboxes. And being so, they said that their new Xbox is going to be 4 to 6 times powerful than the Xbox 360. And basically, when I first read that, 4 to 6 times more powerful than the Xbox 360 using the Blu-ray optical drives, I mean, what does that mean for the PS4 and the PS3? How much more powerful is the PS4 going to be than the Xbox 360 or this new Xbox, if they're saying it's going to be 4 to 6 times more powerful than the Xbox 360? Because we all know that right now that Microsoft has beaten Sony as far as the Xbox, as far as the console wars go, because the Xbox has clearly had sold more units since in 2012 than the PS3 has. And that's clearly because, Microsoft offers better online support and things like that. But besides all that, 4 to 6 times more powerful. Basically what they're saying there is that they're going to be at games like Battlefield 3 and Crysis, which basically have no anti-aliasing, no particle offense, no ambient occlusion and things like that. They're basically saying that they're going to be able to run Crysis and Battlefield 3 on this new Xbox 4 to 6 times over than they can right now in the Xbox 360. And that just blows my mind, because most average gamers today and people who have powerful PCs can only open one or 1.5 windows of Crysis or 1.5 windows of Battlefield 3, because it just takes so much power. And what does this mean for Unreal Engine 4 that I talked about in my first video of the Gamer's Rant? And basically I talked about the future of consoles and things like that. So this has, when they say 4 to 6 times more powerful than the Xbox 360, it really has me thinking. I really don't believe it. I really don't think it's going to be 4 to 6 times more powerful than the Xbox 360. Of course, this 56 page document was written back in 2010, but that was 2.5 years ago. And well, it has almost been 2.5 years ago. And, technology has gone up substantially since 2010 to halfway through 2012. So I'm really looking forward to all this new specifications that are going to be announcing either before E3 or at E3 of next year. So that's going to be very, very exciting to hear when they finally announce this new console. Now, as far as the rumors were going a couple of months ago, when they were talking about that the new consoles are going to be possibly blocking used games on these new consoles, well, that's just asinine. I really don't think it's going to be happening. In this document, there was no mention of blocking used games on their consoles, because if you really think about it, guys, there's no way they can allow to block. There's no way these publishers are going to be allowed to block used games from you playing pre-purchased games on their consoles. Because, let's go ahead and talk about this for a little bit. Like, take video game retail stores, for example, like GameStop and Play and Trade and things like that. There's just no way that they're going to drive those companies out of business, and there's always going to be a need for a retail store when it comes to video games and entertainment, because you always have to buy the accessories. You're always going to have to have a place to, you go to your midnight releases for video games and things like that. Even though we are switching over to a digital age where everything's online, you can just download it. I mean, there are problems with that because most people do have bandwidth caps on their internet. A lot of people just don't have the space on their computers to download all this information and things like that. They'd rather have a physical copy of the artwork on the game boxes, and they'd rather have a physical disc just so they can make it easier to install at later dates. You don't have to re-download the games and things like that. So in my opinion, there's always going to be a need for physical retail stores when it comes to video games and entertainment such as this. So as far as the rumor goes of console blocking used games, I really don't think that the Microsoft and Sony and Nintendo are going to be doing that. As far as the Wii U goes, like I said, the Wii U has made no mention, or Nintendo has made no mention of the Wii U blocking used games. I mean, that's just asinine if you guys actually think about it. But moving on to some of this new features that were, or these major features that were announced in this document, basically Microsoft is moving over towards a huge online cloud storage system. Basically, what this means is that we're probably not going to be seeing any hard drives on the new Xbox. You're not going to have a hard drive. All of your information is going to be stored online on a Microsoft server or something like that. We're probably not going to have to pay for it. It's probably just going to be bundled into the Xbox Live Gold membership or whatever they're going to be doing in this new console, but I figure the prices won't be that bad. But not having a hard drive attached to your console is kind of a big stress reliever, because data is always getting corrupted, and making sure that it's on Microsoft end, their data can get corrupted and hacked into, I guess, if they're not secure enough. But obviously, it's going to be better not to have a hard drive in your system making all that noise, all that read and write that's happening. Your games are going to be loading as much faster because it's all digital and doesn't have to be read off a disc. So that's going to be really awesome, especially when you can, actually, now that I think about it, how's that going to work if you're, right now with your Xbox 360, you can install games to your hard drive for faster read-write times. But I really don't know how that's going to work if they move over to a cloud system where, all your... Well, I guess you're still going to have the game on the disc, but what's happening with the installing your game to a hard drive? Well, I don't know. You guys can go ahead and leave your opinions here in the comments in the YouTube section below, but there is one more thing that I want to talk to you guys about, and I do not remember what that is. Basically, they go on to talk about the lifespan of the console. They hope that this new Xbox is going to be lasting about 10 years, is where the Xbox 360 is sitting at almost around 7 years right now. So they're hoping that this new console, being as 4 to 6 times more powerful, quote-unquote, they're hoping that they're going to be able to extend the lifespan of this new console. As far as details of what the console is going to be named, or what the console is going to look like, or any other specifications such as RAM and graphics and things like that, there was no mention of that in this document. There are similar articles for the Wii U and PlayStation 4 out there, so I encourage you guys to check those out. But that's probably going to wrap it up for this video, guys. I just wanted to go over some of these new features that were mentioned in this 56-page document, and tell you guys a little bit about my opinion of what that's going to be coming with this new console. Also, if you want to hear some more opinions about my new my console, or about the console, you're going to want to check out my Unreal Engine 4 video in the very first episode of my Gamer's Rant series. So I talk about a lot about Unreal Engine 4 and the lifespan and the future of console gaming and things like that. So I encourage you guys to check that out. Also, as a side note, I mentioned this earlier in the video, this 56-page document that these companies are getting all this information from, I mean, it was written back in 2010, but I really do think that this is legitimate information, because I really don't think someone's going to waste all that time putting out a 56-page document that has all to do with these new consoles and things like that. So there has to be some legitimacy to this document, and hopefully it is real. And we'll see more information the beginning of next year, or at E3 next year. So, like I said, go ahead and leave your comments and your questions below in the YouTube comments. Also, if you like this video, go ahead and hit the like button, show your support, and subscribe to my YouTube channel. I really do appreciate all of my subscribers and you guys giving me your support. I'm working really hard to become a YouTube partner. Also, you guys can check over my live streams over at twitch.tv/gamerlcd, where I live stream all the latest and greatest PC games out there. Currently, I'm doing Diablo 3 and World of Warcraft Mists of Pandaria beta, but I also do other games like Bioshock and things like that. All the latest PC games like Ghost Recon, Future Soldier. So go ahead and check out my live streams. I'll put a link in the description below, and you guys can hit the follow button over there. Thank you guys for watching. My name's GamerLCD, and I will see you guys next time.